देखो, सॉल्यूशन ऑफ लीनियर सिस्टम्स इटरेटिव मेथड्स, गॉस जैकोबी मेथड एंड गॉस सीडल मेथड। अर्लियर यू हैव सीन गॉस एलिमिनेशन मेथड एंड गॉस जॉर्डन मेथड। नाउ इन योर सिलेबस देर आर टू मोर मेथड्स फॉर सॉल्विंग लीनियर सिस्टम्स। दीज टू आर इटरेटिव मेथड्स। फर्स्ट इज गॉस जैकोबी मेथड एंड द सेकेंड इज गॉस सीडल इटरेशन मेथड। See, in a direct method, the amount of computation is fixed. You know very well that while you solve an equation by using direct method, the computation goes to an end. So amount of computation is fixed. But in an iterative method, the amount of computation is not fixed. It depends on the accuracy required. Maybe it is up to 5 terms, maybe up to 10 terms, maybe up to 100 terms, and so on. In iterative methods, we repeat the process till the required accuracy is achieved. There is even in the problem that you need to find the accuracy up to certain order. We start from an initial approximation and use it for the next approximation. Suppose we have a system of equations a11x1 plus a12x2 plus so on plus a1nxn is equal to b1, a21x1 plus a22x2 plus so on plus a2nxn is equal to b2, and so on an1x1 plus an2x2 plus so on plus annxn is equal to bn, such that aii are not equal to zero. Means these diagonal coefficients, they are not zero. That is the diagonal elements a11, a22, a31, ann, they are non-zero. If some of these are zero, maybe in some system there are some diagonal coefficients that are zero, then rearrange the system so that the diagonal elements become non-zero. Now rewrite the system in this manner. Rewriting is not a very tough task. Now, rewriting for Gauss-Jacobi method. See, the coefficient of x1 is a11. So divide the whole equation by a11 and put x1 at the left hand side and all the remaining elements at the right hand side. So x1 will be b11, b1 by a11 minus a12 by a11 x2 minus a13 by a11 x3 minus 1 minus a1n by a11 xn. X2 will be B2 by A22 minus A21 by A22, X1 minus A23 by A22, X3 minus 1 minus A21 by A22, Xn. Here the coefficient of X2 is A22 and we divide the whole equation by A22 and put X2 at the left hand side and the remaining elements at the right hand side. Similarly, X3 is B3 by A33 minus A31 by A33, X1 minus A32 by A33, X2 minus A34 by A33 X4 minus 1 minus A3N by X33 AN XN, and so on. XN will be BN by ANN minus AN1 by ANN X1 minus 1 minus ANN minus 1 by ANN XN minus 1. Let us take the first initial approximations. Suppose the first initial approximations be given as X1 1, X2 1, so on XN 1. This superscript is your for first initial approximation. Then from 2, this is our equations, system of equations 2. We have x12 means second approximation. This will be equal to b1 by a11 minus a12 by a11 x21 minus 1 minus a1n by a11 xn1. x22 will be b2 by a22 minus a21 by a22 x11 minus 1 minus a2n by a22 xn1. And similarly, xn2 will be bn by ann minus an1 by ann x11 minus 1 minus ann minus 1 by ann xn minus 1 1. This is our system of equations 3. The next approximations x1n, x2n, and so on xnn produce the n plus 1th approximation. As given below, the x1 n plus 1 will be b1 by a11 minus a12 by a11 x2n minus 1 minus a1n by a1n xnn. and then x2 n plus 1 will be b2 by a22 minus a21 by a22 x1n minus 1 minus a21 by a22 xnn, and xn n plus 1 will be bn by ann minus an1 by ann x1n minus 1 minus ann minus 1 by ann xn minus 1 n. This is our system of equations 4. Thus, the system 4 means this one. This can be written as xn plus 1 is equal to b into capital Xn plus c. This is our equation 5. If you have any query, ask me your questions. Now, this method is due to Gauss-Jacobi and is called the method of simultaneous displacements. Here we are simultaneously displacing the approximations in the next equation. Note, sufficient condition for the convergence of Gauss-Jacobi method is this: norm of B should be less than 1. Now come to Gauss-Seidel method. A simple modification produces this method. In Gauss-Jacobi method, we will modify a simple and get the system 2 will be as x12 is equal to b1 by a11 minus a12 by a11 x21 minus 1 minus a1 by a11 xn1. Using the initial approximations x11, x21, so on, xn1, but from the second equation of system 2 onwards, this is our first equation, but from the second equation onwards, we will have x22 is equal to b2 by a22 minus a21 by a22 x12. Earlier it was x11, but now it will be replaced by this x12, okay, minus a23 by a22 x31 minus 1 minus a21 by nn xn1, and x32 is equal to b3 by a33 minus a31 by a33 x12. Earlier it was x11 minus a32 by a33 x22. Earlier it was x21 minus a34 by a44 x41 minus 1 minus a3n by nn xn1. The remaining variables are substituted as such, and so on. In this way, we complete the first stage. See the difference between Gauss-Jacobi and Gauss-Seidel. We complete the first stage. Repeat this process till the required accuracy is achieved. This method uses an improved component. It is called the method of successive displacements. It is due to Gauss-Seidel. And here the condition for the convergence of both the methods is summation over j is varying from 1 to n, j is not equal to I, modulus of aij by aii less than or equal to 1, and I is varying from 1 to 3, so on, n. There is one example, see one example here. From this example, the idea will be clear. Example. Solve the system by first Gauss-Jacobi method and second by Gauss-Seidel method. 10x1 minus 2x2 minus x3 minus x4 is equal to 3. Minus 2x1 plus 10x2 minus x3 minus x4 is equal to 15. Minus x1 minus x2 plus 10x3 minus 2x4 is equal to 27. Minus x1 minus x2 minus 2x3 plus 10x4 is equal to minus 9. Next, another question, it is solved. Solve the system 10x plus 2y plus z is equal to 9, 2x plus 20y minus 2z is equal to minus 44, minus 2x plus 3y plus 10z is equal to 22 by first Gauss-Jacobi method and second Gauss-Seidel method. See its solution. We take an initial approximation as, take initial approximation as x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0 and z is equal to 0. Suppose all of them are 0. The given system is reduced to, now the equation 1 will be reduced to x is equal to 0.9 minus 0.2x minus 0.1z. Here take 10x is equal to 9 minus 2y minus z and divide the whole by 10. So x will be 0.9 minus 0.2y minus 0.1z. Similarly, take y from this, divide the whole equation by 20 and take put y at the left hand side and the all other at the right hand side. So y will be minus 2.2 minus 0.1x plus 0.1z. Z will be similarly z. Z is equal to 2.2 plus 0.2x minus 0.3z. Now see Gauss-Jacobi method. N is n for first x, y, z. Take x is equal to 0.9. For y 0, z 0. X will be 0.9. Y will be minus 2.2 and z will be 2.2. Here for y z and x 0, x will be this, y will be this, z will be this. Next, the second approximation is x is equal to 1.12, y is equal to 0.207, z is equal to 0.334. See here, x2 will be 0.9 minus 0.2 into minus 2.2 minus 0.9 into 2.2. So this is equal to 1.12. So this is your x2. Next, y2 is minus 2.2 minus 0.1 into 0.9 plus 0.1 into 2.2. So it is equal to minus 0.207. Here it is written. Similarly, z2 will be 2.2 plus 0.2 into 0.9 minus 0.3 into 2.2. See here, this is z. So substitute here the values of x and y. So z2 will be 0.334. It is written here. This is our Gauss-Jacobi method. Here we have not made use of x1 in the successive approximations. Next, Gauss-Seidel method. Take x0, y0, x0, 0 is equal to x0 is equal to 0, y0, 0, z0, 0. So x1 will be 0.9. So and 1, 2, x, y, z, x1 is 0.9. But y1 will be different. Y1 is equal to, see the formula, minus 2.2 minus 0.1x. But here x will be substituted by x1. So y1 will be minus 2.2 minus 0.1 into, this is your x1, 0.9. Earlier it was 0, but now it is, earlier it was x0, but now it is x1 plus 0.1 into 0. This is our z0, but this is our x1. So its value is minus 2.29, minus 2.29. Similarly, z1 is 2.2 plus 0.2 into 0.9 minus 0.3 into 0. So it is 2.38. This is our x1. This is our y1. See here, this is our z0, not y1, it is z0. So x2 is, z2 is 2.38. Similarly, you can calculate x2, y2, and z2, and so on. Okay, so this is all about today's portion. If you have any query or any difficulty, you can ask me your question, and this will be available